mainly into hydro power, and then due to failure of some rains during certain period, we went into the thermal generation category. And we have in our Karnataka Power Corporation a hydro capacity of 3,652.35 megawatt capacity, and in thermal we have got 2,720 megawatt capacity, and in the Karnataka we are meeting nearly 50% of state's requirement of energy. We mainly first station we went into was at the Raichur, and it is called Raichur Thermal Power Station, and we have got there 7 units of 210 megawatt capacity and one of 250 megawatt capacity, and we have got an installed capacity of 1720 megawatt, and our first unit was commissioned in 1984. Our first unit was commissioned during 1984, and the last unit, that is of 250 megawatt, was commissioned in 2010. We have the boilers there of all BHEL make, and all turbine sets except unit 4 are from BHEL. Unit 4 turbine we have got it from MHI. And our coal supplies are mainly from the north, central and north India, and we are getting from Andhra Pradesh also, we are getting coal, and in western coal field and in Mahanadi coal field, from there we are getting the coal. And then to increase the capacity of our generation capacity, we have again started another thermal units in Ballari. We call it Ballari Thermal Power Station. We have got at present 2 of 500 megawatt, and first unit was commissioned during 2008 and second was commissioned during 2012. Boiler and turbine are all of BHEL make one. We are now erecting one 700 megawatt supercritical generating unit, which is of BHEL design and is scheduled to commission during December 2015. And coal for this we are getting it from Mahanadi coal field. It is a dedicated from Maharashtra, and it is a dedicated main for us. We are operating it on joint venture. And we have started another near Raichur only, another in a place called Ermeras. We have started another two critical supercritical technology, two units. It's of each of 800 megawatt. This erection work is going on. It is the first unit is about to be commissioned in December 2015, and second unit at the end of early 2015 we are going to commission it somewhere in March, and second unit by the end of 2015. And one more unit is also in the campus of Raichur Thermal Power Station only, in the compound. There is another place called Edlapur, and there also we are planning one of 800 megawatt units. This is all based on supercritical technology. As on today, that is, we have renewable energy sources, we have about 12.12%, hydro we have got about 16.68%, and nuclear 1.97% in Karnataka, and then thermal we have got about 69.23%. Total installed capacity of our Karnataka Power Corporation is 2,43,028.9. Our colleague from Ms. BHEL is speaking on. Thank you.
Good morning to everybody, and thanks ARC for my introduction. So actually the previous slide is showing the India's installed capacity as on 31st March 2014. This is as per the CEA report, wherein the thermal sets contribute about 69%, other nuclear is 1.97 and renewable 12.12 and hydro 16.68%. The Indian power scenario, you can see from this slide, in the 12th plan, the supercritical sets are increasing and subcritical sets are decreasing. In the 13th plan, it is further supercritical sets are more and subcritical sets are less. So it shows the environment concern of Government of India, wherein in the 12th plan itself they mentioned as a goal about 20% reduction in this emissions across the country. So this can be achieved by introducing supercritical sets, which gives better efficient power for the same fuel burning. This the next slide, this slide shows about the BHEL's manufacturing units spread across the country. BHEL has got about 17 manufacturing units and 18 service divisions, more than 100 project sites and 4 sectors for the services rendering to the all the project sites. Coming to electronic division, our business area, control and instrumentation, transmission, transportation, solar cells and photovoltaics. Brief overview of electronic division. BHEL electronic division ties up with the Metso Automation for DCS under collaboration agreement for both Max DNA and Metso DNA. BHEL has facilities and expertise for system engineering with Max DNA, Metso DNA, and manufacturing of Max DNA and Metso DNA modules. System testing, we have the state of art technology, and erection and commissioning technical support we can provide from the sectors as well as from the electronics division. We have cumulative running hours has crossed over 30 lakh hours in over 270 units. Engineering of all rating, subcritical up to 600 megawatt and supercritical up to 800 megawatt. Total megawatt, Max DNA and Metso DNA all put together, it is about 1,37,546 megawatts. This slide shows the electronic division's market share when compared relatively to other vendors, DCS vendors in the country as well as rest of the world. So we are having about 45.2% market share. Unified solution for C&I from BHEL electronics division. Thermal sets right from 15 megawatt to 800 megawatt, we are providing controls like SG controls, TG controls, station C&I, HMI, power plant SCADA, PADO, that is performance analysis, diagnostic and optimization, offsite balance of plant controls. In addition to this, we are giving control systems for hydro controls also, auto sequencer, governor control, remote operation, HMI and optimization packages. Similarly, for combined cycle power plants in the captive power plant as well as in the refinery process stream as well as the power. DCS solution from BHEL. So far we are talking about the power block area. In the offsite area also, we started providing control systems in place of PLCs. Earlier days, like coal handling, ash handling, DM water, then AC ventilation system, these packages were controlled through PLC systems. Now we are in a position to provide controls in a unified platform, that is either MaxDNA or MetsoDNA, for the offsite packages. It covers, as listed shown in the slide. Why we are giving these kind of controls for the offsite packages? What advantage customer is going to get from this? Like advantages to customer by providing unified solutions, common DCS platform for entire plant instead of separate PLCs, ease of connectivity and maintenance, monitoring and operability local and central, inventory management by the end user, means he no need to keep the inventory for various control systems. He can keep what is the bare minimum inventory is required, that can be maintained. Familiarity for operation and maintenance engineers, as well as the engineers can be swapped from the various subsystems offsite as well as main plant and across the various units. This is the new generation platform what BHEL electronic division is offering. This is a collaborated product which is completely in-house, indigenized, and being solutions are being worked out across this hardware. And engineering is carried out using virtual engineering servers. So far, electronic division handled supercritical projects. Bara 3x660, Lalitpur Power Generation Company Limited 3x660, which is based on MetsoDNA hardware. Ermaras 2x800 megawatt, it is based on the MaxDNA. Bellary Phase 3, 1x700 megawatt, based on MaxDNA. Projects under execution. Recently, we got a EPC contract from NTPC, that is 3x660 North Karanpura, which is under execution. Suratgarh 2x660, IBVL 2x660, Gadarwara 2x800 megawatt. Some more projects are in the pipeline. We are expecting current year we are going to get. Regarding supercritical sets, why it is called supercritical? If the steam pressure is more than 221 bar, it is called supercritical. Steam temperature is more than 374.15. Ultra supercritical pressure is more than 300 bar. What we gain out of supercritical sets? The efficiency of supercritical sets is 4.3% higher than the subcritical sets. Steam power plant efficiency increases with the increase in steam pressure and temperature. Power plant cycle operating above critical pressure, that is 221 point bar, are classified as supercritical cycles. With the higher efficiency, the supercritical cycle offers the advantage of burn less fuel for the same output and lower emissions. That means the SOx, NOx and carbon dioxide is reduced. This is the configuration we adopted in Ballari 1x700 megawatt based on Max DNA. These are the few graphics what we implemented in Lalitpur and Bara project. Large thermal power projects like Sagardihi 2x500 megawatt, totally Metso DNA based, including cooling water FOPH systems, integrated system handles more than 19,000 physical IOs and more than 300 operator displays, 43 pairs of controllers, more than 1,200 drives. This is regarding the subcritical control systems. Lalitpur is a supercritical set. The number of IOs drastically increased, more than 25,000 physical IOs. Similarly, 60 pairs of controllers, more than 1,800 drives. So, in the meantime, BHEL has developed new applications like LVS alarms for the power plant. It is not in the main plant as well as in the offsite also. This large video screens have been provided for alarm annunciation and alarm analysis systems, APT analysis, wireless connectivity on MaxNet, history replay. From the data already stored in the history, the same graphic can be replayed using replay software. Then APT DM, then IEC connectivity for numerical relays, which has been successfully implemented in various sites. Wireless connectivity on MaxNet. From the central control room, it has been connected to FOPH and cooling water pump house. This maximum configuration we adopted in Dadri 2x490 megawatt, which is successfully working. There are about 2 units, about spread across 25 square kilometers, the control system. All are connected through fiber optic. Like some of the offsites platforms, what we have implemented for the, like flue gas desulfurization and water treatment plant. Flue gas desulfurization control system has been implemented in Bangaigaon thermal power plant. This is the, I think, in India first time we have done. Similarly, earlier the DM water pretreatment was used to be done using PLCs. We have implemented in Max DNA for the HNPCL Vizag, and it is commissioned and it is running. The mechanical and other process side, it is a GE system supplied through our Ranipet unit. Similarly, we have for Lalitpur, we have done using Metso DNA, which is Webag is our supplier mechanical. Again, it is through customer is placed out on Webag. It is here the difference between the Lalitpur and HNPCL Vizag. Here the EDI technology has been used in HNPCL Vizag. In Lalitpur, it's a mixed bed technology, the final before the water is demineralized water is supplied to the tank. Then other is HPCL import facility. This is the facility we have implemented using Max DNA at Mangalore HPCL import. When the ship comes, the crude oil is pumped to a distance of 4 kilometers. This signal communication is established through fiber optic link. for the special projects with the Max DNA. We have supplied graphical interface units at 35 various field locations for assisting during local operation interfaced through Modbus. This has been implemented in NTPC projects and it is successfully commissioned also. This is the ECS configuration what we have adopted for various projects, oil sector projects like IOCL Mathura, IOCL Bangaigaon, IOCL Paradeep and GSPC Kakinada, Opal Dahej. In Opal Dahej, we have supplied raw water treatment plant using Max DNA. It is under commissioning and it is successfully tested also. It is first system which is going into the refinery segment what we have supplied, Max DNA. This is in place of PLC. So we are not only doing the greenfield jobs. We do take up R&M projects with the Max DNA as well as Metso DNA. Commissioning of R&M job done in record 30 days for Roper. Commissioning of R&M job done in 33 days in IB Valley. Other R&M jobs, Vijayawada, Trombe, Tata Job Job, Vera, Reliance, Dano, Vizag Steel Plant and 15 industrial turbines. Right now we are doing KDF, that is Korba, Dadri, Farakka, where Dadri R&M, about four sets we are doing R&M, complete C&I. In the earlier system, various vendors have supplied. Now those systems are being replaced with the Max DNA. In a unified solution, we are providing. Thank you very much for the listening.